students in your syllabus third unit of the paper in academic integrity and plagiarism, there is a point of discussion is the direct quotation. This is an academic activity where we all are aware of from probably post-matric days. While reading a book, you must have seen reading a book, you must have seen how the students, how the authors have quoted, like mostly it's very familiar way, according to so and so, with inverted comma and putting inverted comma end, you know. So this is very common form of while writing, especially in academic writing. So why do I repeat again and again academic writings? Academic writing sometimes I write something or an author writes something, it has a relation with the topic, and either corroborating, either rejecting or supporting a knowledge claim in any field. Maybe it is in chemistry, maybe it is in history, in political, whatever. So we are claiming something. While claiming something, so we may need to put some kind of arguments from others in support of our things. It's a direct, when you copy or you borrow or lend certain things as it is, verbatim, word by word, direct from the, you know, without changing in even a single iota of things like a word or a punctuous marks. So that is direct quotations. That is very safe rather that way. And according to the rules, different style manuals, like in our other models, you can see how these style manuals, how the style manual works. Like in that case, you can put your punctuation mark or inverted comma, in-text citations, and the rules to provide the list of references. According to the rule, you can do that. Indirect is a very safest way. There is nothing wrong in understanding this aspect. But in otherwise, you difficult to understand. Like, but in direct quotations also, a couple of things comes to mind or questions are raised. Is that from which sources you may borrow? Which sources? It's very difficult to say which sources. The author is the manager, the sole authority, whosoever write or writes, author or authors. Like from which sources? From which source means from which book? Book, journal articles, from which sources we need to borrow, and how much materials, how much words or sentences we need to borrow from others, and then third is when to borrow. So all these aspects are, you know, the author is the sole authority in that way. So this is direct quotations. And you say that suppose the author is beginning writing, and after 10 years or 15 years, and the same author will have a different impression about direct quotations. But the golden rules are, like the students used to ask in the workshop in classroom also, how much quoted matters can be considered. As such, there is no rule. And rules are created by the different journals also. They frame the rules, okay, your quotations or your citations, or the when you directly quoting, you cannot go beyond 10, 5, 10, 20 words or sentences. But as such, but the golden rule says that you pick up less and less number of, I mean, your cited matter should be, so that, you know, that is better rather. And how many times I should cite, then again it doesn't have, suppose someone is writing on a very sensible issue or a very debatable issue, obviously more and more number of citations are needed to establish his or her thesis. But in case of very generalized, so don't require much citation from other sources. This is the case. But sometimes especially my PhD students think, suppose more and more number of citations, even for a smaller and generalized kind of topics, it looks that author is very good, article shows. Anyway, it's very, all these things are controversial. So direct quotations there. And direct quotation can be said even one word also. One word, two word, three words, two sentences and paragraph also. But you that way. And people say, suppose there are myth and misconceptions about this. Suppose someone directly quoted many books, many sources by rule according to different styles, by rule one after another, direct quoted and completes a book or completed an article. So in that case, whether it is plagiarized or not, it's very difficult to make a decision on this. The golden rule says that the author is supposed to write of his own or her own, and very rare cases, if it is needed, if it is required, and amount of cited matters required, then you may cite or take direct quotations with a norm. Like we have different styles, manuals like MLA or APA, and there are other sources also. I hope direct quotations are clear to you. If it is not, then gradually you will come to know. Maybe from other sources, maybe by writing experiences, and when you grow old, gradually. Bye-bye.